What is up, people? Arcanjr here, bringing you Clowns, my Destiny review. So start things off with the presentation. Opens very nicely, it's engaging, and graphics are very good, especially the landscape-wise and in details. Very good-looking game, very impressive for MMO. I'll get into that later. Characters could look a bit more better facially. They didn't really do any kind of improvements customization-wise from the beta. They didn't make, like, there's still no new hairstyles, no facial hairs, no different eye colors, or it's still the exact same it was in the beta. So they didn't do any kind of improvement to the character customization, which kind of sucks to me, but you know, it is what it is. Now, I've mentioned this in a few of my beta videos about how impressive this game looks compared to MMOs. Compared to other games, it isn't as impressive, but to MMOs, it usually doesn't have amazing graphics because of how large the areas are and how many people are in the game. So graphic wise, this game is very impressive compared to MMOs, and graphics in general are never the focus of MMOs in the first place. Now, this cannot be described as a true MMO. It's really a FPS with MMO elements. You know how you have some games that throw in other elements of other genres into their games just to make the game somewhat better. So this is just another FPS shooter with MMO elements into it. It's not a true MMO. It's not like Guild Wars or World of Warcraft or Elder Scrolls Online. Or WarStar. It's not a true MMO. That's not a bad thing. You know, the features that it does have, that's similar to MMOs, is very good. The features that it has the shooters is very good. But maybe the reason that this game looks better than most MMOs is because there isn't many locations. A lot of the missions you're just gonna go through the same places over and over again. You know, you're gonna go to some of the Moon, Venus, Mars, and Earth. And on Earth, you're only in one location. You're recycling that same location over and over again. So it's not like this is a very vast game. Now, it sucks that you can only do story missions with two other friends. So story fire team is only three, raid fire team is on three, multiplayer is 6v6. So it does kind of suck that the number of players that be in the fire team at a certain time is that low. But you know, the maps are catered to the number of players. I would just say that. The max level is 20, but if you get Motes of Light, you can level up your equipment beyond that, and you'll have your character will appear as higher than 20, even though it will show that you're 20 when you press start and go into the menu. Enemies spawn pretty fast, so if you want, you can put in the grind. You can easily farm kills and level up. You can easily go to the open world area of old Russia and just sit there and do all the little mini missions and just sit and kill over and over again. You can level up fast that way. I've seen a lot of people so far do that. Some people who are level 3, they just go right into the little cosmodrome area and just start farming so they can get to level 8 so they can be better. The story, well, there isn't much to say about the story. The game lacks cutscenes, it lacks dialogue, and it lacks a sense that there's actually a story. Now, it's noticeable that this is a gameplay-heavy game, and it's not a story-driven game at all. No, especially compared to like Bungie past titles, you would expect there to be a very, very engaging, very, very immersive, very well-told story behind this game. Really, there isn't much of a story to talk about. Now, frankly, the beta was nothing more but an early look at the final product. The beta was not a beta, it was a demo. The first missions you go through in the game are the exact same missions you go through in the beta. Obviously, the deeper you get into the game, there's more to do, and there's more missions, there's more cutscenes, but still, it's very limited, it's not a lot, it's not enough to say this is a very engaging story. No, I'll reference Defiance to give you an idea of the story for this game. It's very similar to how the story is being told in Defiance. And that's not to say that the story is bad. It isn't a bad story, it's just it lacks things. It lacks things I've mentioned before. You know, you would expect better from Bungie. In terms of the gameplay is great. The game runs very smoothly. Weapon scenes right and fit well. There does need to be more guns and different looking guns, as most guns are the same gun, just different colors or different names. Kind of lazy on Bungie's part, but it's more of a here's a bunch of guns and they all perform in different ways, but they all look exactly alike. You know, the game is kind of repetitive. Every mission scene is the same. Deploy goals, kill ways and enemies. Deploy goals, kill more ways than enemies, or kill ways than enemies so you can deploy your ghost and then kill another wave after that. This is a game about grinding. If you're not into games that require grinding, you won't like this one. Now, the gameplay The mechanics all perfectly flow well. As I said, it's very smooth. Everything seems perfectly executed mechanically, as I said before. Melee needs to be a one-hit kill from behind, though. It's inconsistent. Sometimes it is, sometimes it isn't. So they need to kind of need to find a balance between how to have the melee. The game does feel dull at some points, and that there isn't enough loot crates. They don't respond soon enough. Not to say that you should be able to farm loot crates, but when someone else uses a loot crate and you go in that area to try to get that loot crate, it's already gone, so you have to wait for it to come back, and the wait time is pretty long. And you need to have enough loot crates and anything that's similar to an MMO. MMOs are the heart and soul of MMO is the community and the ability to find loot. Our brain wants loot when it comes to MMOs. In terms of the multiplayer, otherwise known as the Crucible, is a mixed bag. At times it's really fun, very competitive, and similar to Crysis and Halo. Then there's times where someone's your Titanfall in the wrong way. It'll take a lot of shots to kill someone at times. People can run away from your bullets. Weapons seem inconsistent, and it's obvious the auto rifle is the go-to weapon for most. However, there isn't any overpowered weapons. You know, you might hear from some people go, this gun's overpowered, this gun's overpowered. There isn't any overpowered guns in this game that I've noticed. Yes, like I said, the auto rifle is the go-to gun, but it doesn't mean it's the overpowered gun. You know, you can either take people out who use auto rifle with any other weapon in the game, but it's just a better weapon. And again, there is no, like, again, when it comes to people saying I'm something overpowered, it's usually I keep getting killed by this one gun over and over again, so that means that gun must be unbalanced. In this game, I don't really see that. You know, I've been killed by the all rifle, I've been killed by the scout rifle, I've been killed by the handgun. I'm not gonna say all three of those weapons are overpowered, because I just got killed by it, that's it. And then there's the community. The majority of the people in the Crucible are either one or all of the above between camper, vehicle whores, or cheesing with shotguns, or walking around shooting rockets. You know, the community is the same community that you would get from any other multiplayer shooter, like Call of Duty and Battlefield. Playing with friends is recommended when playing in Crucible, as randoms are the typical FPS randoms that don't do a thing but die and avoid playing objective. The game mechanics make TDM seem like the perfect place to play multiplayer, but playing the other game modes are fun as well. But again, majority of your success will come from having a solid team or getting lucky by playing with randoms who are actually somewhat decent. You know, overall, though, Bungie themselves did a great job with the multiplayer. Most of the issues are all community, really, in my opinion. The biggest issue with multiplayer is the class specials. The class specials work the same way you can get in a Titan Wars in Titanfall. Everybody gets it. You don't have to actually do a thing, but it does go up faster if you're getting kills, capping flags, getting assists, etc. And in my opinion, you should only be able to get that little special ability by getting kills. You know, have it work as some type of kill streak. Go on like a 5 kill streak or 6 or 7 kill streak, and then you get your class special. Not to mention, so far, class specials seem to be a bit unbalanced, as a Hunter's is less effective than a Warlock and Titan. As I said before, they should each counter the other. No, the Hunter counters the Warlock, Warlock counters the Titan, Titan counters the Hunter. This is how it should have been, and that would have balanced the character classes out, as a Hunter is the obvious lesser of the three, and thus the more skill required to use. The pre-order bonuses are meh. You get this little Sparrow, which only difference between the in-game Sparrow and the one you get from pre-ordering the game is the color. The Vanguard Armory, you don't get anything free. It's just the early access to weapons you'll generally get later in the game, or exclusively for those who pre-ordered the game. You still have to purchase those weapons with in-game currency. Bungie said it takes longer to level up to level 8 than it did in the beta. That was a lie, because I got to level 8 just as fast as I did in the beta. That is a negative, though. I'm just mentioning that just to mention it. It's not a negative. Final thoughts on Destiny. Destiny is a game of many faces. You're either going to enjoy it and see it for its potential, or you're going to be turned off by it. You know, it lacks character dialogue, sometimes dull moments, and multiplayer that's different from any other multiplayer you've played previous shooters. For me, it's an enjoyable game that I look forward to putting even more hours into. A game with a story engaging enough to keep you interested and occupied, but again, it still lacks a lot that makes you immersed into the story. For me, most of my time will be spent in a story as I'm not that interested in multiplayer. To get an idea of what Destiny is, imagine Crysis, Defiance, Halo, and Borderlands all fused together, you get this game. My final score for Destiny is an 8.5 out of 10. It'd be better if the story had more and better dialogue and more interesting cutscenes, and plus the crates issue. I talked about it before, the multiplayer also keeps it from being a 10, but not by a lot. Its biggest flaws is the FPS community. This is a game I'll trade in after I finish the story, as after that there is really any reason to keep the game. But that's it for me, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know what your thoughts on in the comment section. Peace out, Jabronis. I'll see you next time.